Now, for those of you who are just starting off with us, don't be alarmed. The quiz won't count for you, but for all those regulars, it will. Let's stand with our feet shoulder-width apart, and let's just slowly bend from side to side, bending your knee into the center. Don't matter what you look like. There you go. You got it. Just bend and bend. Bend and bend. All we're doing is we're just getting the circulation going here. And now let's incorporate some arm movements. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and reaching, same leg, same knee. Nice, easy, fluid movements. Now, here's your first question. Why do we do this? Why do we warm up in this fashion? Think about it. Good. That's right. It's because we're trying to increase circulation gradually, increase blood flow gradually. Very good. 1 out of 1. For those of you who are just starting off with this, that's right. It's just to increase circulation flow. It's very important that you do that before you do any stretching. And we'll see if our regulars know why. Let's count down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stand with your hands on your waist. Walk your feet in. And walk your feet right back out again. We're doing this for a reason. We've done it before. Do you know why we're doing it? Think about it. Good. Spit it out. You've got it. There you go. Okay. It's to just increase the circulation once again, but also it is to get our feet warmed up, get our ankles warmed up, because during our up-and-coming cardiovascular section, we will be doing some jumping and bouncing, so it's only fair that we warm up our feet too. That's right. Good. Let's count down to do some light stretching. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And now with our feet shoulder width apart, let's reach out at shoulder height and stretch to the right. And now, why is it that we did increase our circulation before we did some stretching? Remember? It's because you should have blood flowing and circulating to the muscle sites before you actually do any form of stretching. Good, I'm impressed. You're impressing me. 3 out of 3, not bad. And why are we doing this stretch? Why not some other stretch? Why are we stretching the side? Remember? It's because sometimes you do develop cramping along the sides, and this helps to alleviate it. Okay, good. 4 out of 4. Come out, not bad. Come back to the center, hands around our waists, and let's do some twisting. And when we twist, we're keeping two things forward. Blank and blank. Fill in those blanks. We're keeping our hips forward and we're keeping our eyes forward so that we're isolating our waistlines. Good. 5 out of 5. You're all going to pass those flying colors. Let's count down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Walk your feet back in. Let's start with our march. That's right. We always start off with the march. Now you explain why we start off with the march. Explain it to your friends that you're exercising with, or just go over it in your mind. What do I usually say here? That's right. That's very, very right. We always start off with our march because it's another way to gradually increase the blood flow, to increase circulation. The key word is gradually. We do everything gradually here. And it's very important that we are exercising on a carpet and that we are wearing footwear. Good. And that our backs are flat and that our shoulders are blank and blank. Up and back. And our upper bodies are very, very relaxed. Right. Not bad. There's one very important thing that I'm going to ask you. You should all get this right. Boy, oh boy, if you don't, I might take off 5 points just for not knowing this. When you land, how do you land? Think about it. That's right. You land on the ball of your foot and then you roll to your heel. Why? Why is it important to land on the ball of your foot and to roll to your heel, not to stay up on the ball of your foot? Because we don't want to develop shin splints or leg problems. Good. Very good. Let's count down to our beginner and intermediate levels. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And let's just twist. Arms are by our sides. You're doing very well. I'm pleased. I wondered how much you were retaining, because it's very important that you know what we're exercising and why we're exercising it. No sense in just getting up and jumping around and not knowing any of the mechanics. Good. You've done very, very well. Sometimes, you know, you listen, but you don't listen. I was just worried that maybe you were doing that. I should have known better, though. That's good. Nice and easy. Make sure we're getting our heels down. Let's incorporate our movements. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Arms up and twisting. Okay, now, it's very important that you count down with me. Do you remember why? Why do I ask you to count down? Go back to yesterday's class. I say it each day. That's right. Because it's your way to gauge how hard you're working. If you're working so hard that you can't count down with me, then you're working far too hard. And you slow down the pace. Good. Almost word for word. Let's keep going. Make sure that we're getting that heel down. Twist, twist. Now the beginners are stepping and doing a twist. Working our waistlines here. Working our heart and lungs. Gradually. Working our arms by twisting. Let's count down to change. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hands on our waist. Just bring our heels up to the back. Now, do you remember what we're working in this exercise? Which muscle groups? You don't need to know the technical names. Where are they located? Point. That's right, fronts and backs. We're stretching out the fronts of our legs, and we're working the backs of our legs. Good. Now, while your hands are on your waists, they should be very, very relaxed. Good. Fill in the blanks day today. Bring your heels up. Let's count down to incorporate some light arm movement. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Just reaching forward. Reach forward and reach up. Beginners are stepping, bringing their feet up behind. There we go, and they're reaching up too. Let's reach up nice and high. Palms flat. Good. Big, deep, blanks, breath. You know what you're doing. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and hands on your waist, dragging on the spot. Little step, like some flash dance. There we go. Make sure that your backs are still flat. Good. Shoulders are up, back, and relaxed. Right. And roll to that heel. Right. You got it. Keep going. This is the only way I can give you a little quiz, just to see how well you're listening. There you go. Bring your knees up. Let's work on bringing them up now. Beginners are doing a form of a march, so bringing their knees up too. There we go. Now, if that's a little bit too difficult for you, just bring your knees down. And bring them up if you can. Okay. Hands on your waist. Relax those fingertips. Play the piano. There you go. Okay, let's count down to change. 10, 9, 8, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Heel up. Kick in. Get that heel right up. Good. Today, during our SOS section, which stands for soft odd spots, we're going to concentrate on the hip and thigh region. We'll do a beginner and intermediate level, just as we're doing for our cardiovascular section. Let's go. Count down to incorporate our movements. Ready? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Circle out. Keep your arms up at shoulder height. Reach with our fingertips. There we go. Good kick out. Now, it's very important that you're reaching with your fingertips and that you're not clenching your fists. That may result in neck straining problems. You may feel tension in through your neck. Relax your fingertips. Play the piano. There we go. Good. Or play the saxophone in this case. Good. Keep going. Okay, relax your fingertips. Let's count down to change. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and again. Knees up. Come on. So we're going to get your knees up. Let's really concentrate on working the fronts of our legs. Bring them up. Backs are flat. Good. Bring them up. Let's jog forward. Jog back. Bring those knees up. Jog forward. And back. Okay, let's incorporate some arm movements. Get our hearts working a little bit harder. 10, 9, 8, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and reach. Reach way up, come on. Beginners are doing the same exercise, however, they're not bouncing. Come on. Work hard. Reach. Let's come down. 5, 3, 2, 1, hands on your waist, jumping forward and back. Bend your knees. Forward and back. There we go. Let's count down to appropriate arm movements. 5, 4, 3, 2. Beginners are doing a variation. Reach and pull, come on. Got a hair in my mouth. Come on. This really moves. Come on, reach. Elbows at shoulder height. Good. Big deep breaths. So far, so good. You're scoring perfect on your quiz. Let's side to side. Bend those knees, reach those arms. Count down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lightly jog on the spot. Lightly jogging. Beginners are rolling. Beginners are lightly jogging. Very good. Now let's take our pulse rates. That's right, come on. Continue moving, it's very important. Locate your pulse rate using the first two fingers of your hand, either on your wrist or more accurately on your neck. Count for 10 seconds, beginning now. Stop counting, keep your legs moving. This is old hat. Find the number that you've counted along the side. You find your number and age along the bottom. Now where the two meet in the graph should hopefully be somewhere within this blue area here, just to give you a general idea as to how hard you're working. Okay? So right along here you should be working. Okay? We're going to a commercial break now. We're going to concentrate on working our hips and thighs. So please come back. You can have a sip of water if you like, but keep warm, keep moving. See you in a bit. Time for our SOS. Let's concentrate on our hips and thighs. Down on your sides. Beginners are following me in the corner. Let's roll down slowly. Get into the fetal position with your weight coming forward. Both feet are here like so. What you're going to do is bring your leg up, and we're going to pulsate up and down. There we go. And now the beginners are coming up and down, but they're resting. Why do they rest? Do you know? It's because they are just beginners. It's because we're going to feel this very shortly right here. And what it is it's a tightening of our muscle because our muscles aren't used to working. So they're going to take a break to just try and alleviate some of the stiffness, okay? You're doing well. I'm really surprised that you're remembering all that you're remembering. It's good. It's important. Thank you for making one of my goals come true, because I was hoping that this information that I'm passing on would become part of your everyday life. You know, that you would remember it and recognize certain aspects of exercise as being right or wrong, or knowing how to exercise properly. And that's super. I think it's great that you've learned to keep going up and down, just pulsating. By pulsating, such as we are, we're really concentrating, we're really isolating this muscle right here. If you put your hand right here, you're going to feel it working. So keep your weight leaning forward. That takes pressure off the lower back. That's right. If we're leaning forward, lean into it. Good. Up and down. Just nice, easy pulses. Can you feel that? You can't feel it with your hand. Can you feel it internally? You can feel your muscles starting to tighten up a little bit. Don't be alarmed. We'll stretch it out during our cool down. Let's count down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring your knee up and down. There we go. Just bring it forward and back. Now you can feel that muscle working as you bring your knee forward and back. Yeah, you can feel that. Good. Feel a bit of a pinch. That's okay. We'll stretch you out. Good. Bring it up. Up and down. Lean forward. Good. Beginners are bringing up and down and then they're resting. So if you would like to do the beginner level for our SOS section and do the intermediate level for cardiovascular, or however you want to mix and match, fine by me. No problem at all. Let's count down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's straighten out our toe. Bring our leg out in front and pulsate forward. Woohoo. Feel that? Ugh. Come on, keep going. Let's count down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bend your knee. Bring it down. Rest briefly and come on up. Let's exercise the other side. Down we go, into the fetal position. We're down here, bring your knee up and down, up and down, up and down, control it. Place your hand here. Why is it that I always ask you to touch the certain muscle groups that we're working? Do you remember why? Think about it a bit. It's not because I'm silly, and I want you to look silly. It's because I feel that it's important, it's encouragement for you. When you can see results, when you can feel results, then that gives you inspiration and motivation to want to keep exercising, right? I hope so. Just feel it, you can feel it working. And it's the same thing that I do exercises that are exercises that you'll really feel, because then that way you know you're working, you can feel something, so you know you're doing yourself some good. Up and down. Beginners are coming up and down and they're resting for two. And just keep pulsating. Isolate that muscle right there. Feel it? My other one's still burning. That's normal. It's natural. Let's count down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring your knee forward. Bring it forward, don't take any breaks. Bring it forward. Now you can probably feel a little bit in the front leg, but more so right here, right in this hip area. Right in the gluteus maximus, your hip, whatever you want to call it, right here. Feel a little bit of pinch. It's good. There is a muscle there. Believe it or not, we all have two, one on each side. Maybe difficult to feel at first. After a while, it's going to come along. It's coming down. 9, you feel it? 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Straighten out your leg. Toe forward and pulsate. Let's count down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bend that knee slowly. Straighten out the bottom leg. Straighten it out, bring that knee up, bring it down, and lie back. Feel a nice stretch in through here. Nice stretch, just relax it. And roll over to the other side and do the same thing during this commercial break. Can you please come back for a cool down? Let's continue stretching from side to side, just like we did during the commercial break. Just feel a nice stretch. This is an excellent stretch for our hip area. And you'll notice that during our cool down, I always show you stretches for the areas that we work during SOS. One more question. Why? I told you time after time. Do you remember why? That's close, that's true. It's because the areas that we've worked during SOS, we've worked very hard. and chances are very good that you're going to be a little bit stiff tomorrow, especially in those areas. So I show you exercises. We concentrate on exercises that are geared towards stretching out those areas that we work during SOS, so that tomorrow when you wake up and if you're feeling a little bit stiff, or even if you're not, you can stretch out those areas by doing the exercises that I'm showing you. Chances are you might be stiff, especially if you haven't exercised for a while. Don't be alarmed. It's just your muscles saying we've worked. You know, but please keep us working. They want to keep working. They want to keep stretching. So they're going to keep reminding you that they're there and they want to be exercised. Come back to the center. Let's stretch once more. Bring your knee right up, right over. Feel a nice stretching through your hip. That's good. And back to the center. Now let's cross our right leg over our left. Bring our hands up behind our left leg. Join them and slowly work on bringing our right knee to our chest. Again, this is another nice stretch. For those of you who may have guessed, I'm a teacher, that's right. But, you know, it's interesting because I just wanted to see how much you're retaining. And I'm really pleased that you are retaining a lot. And it's probably interesting for yourself, too, to know that you know how to exercise properly now. You know do's and don'ts. And that's got to be encouraging for you. There you go. Just bring it up slowly. Feel a nice stretch. We hold each stretch for at least how many seconds? This one might be tough. For at least 5 seconds, that's right. Just to give your muscles a chance to actually stretch. Now, for those of you who have been doing our program or who are regulars, I'm going to give you 2 bonus points if you can answer these next 2 questions. They're coming up shortly. Keep you in suspense for a while. And once more, just bring it up. A nice stretch. Bring it up. Deep breaths, just relax. And slow down. Both knees down, bring your knees to your chest, and just squeeze. Here's your bonus question. I'd like to thank you for joining me. Do you remember my name?